So I'm just going to move to the Olympics briefly. I told you guys right from the beginning when we talked about the Olympics in Brazil that there was feces, human feces floating where they were going to do the boating.
There's pictures of it in the newspaper.
Yeah,
right?
It's and they're not Hershey bars or O. Henry's.
Well, there's no coincidence. It's called Lake Excrement, so there's no surprise there.
Or a shitty lake. So here's my thing. Brazil was criticized and just bitch slapped by the press on this stuff, right?
Rightfully so.
Rightfully so.
Oh.
And they lost a lot of real Olympians with all the shit. And when I say shit, ladies and gentlemen, take that literally. That's going on there. Several camera crews, several news teams that we're covering have been robbed.
Well, you know, that's a whole separate issue. The police haven't been paid there in over a month. So, I mean, all of a sudden now you have corruption with law enforcement. They're trying to make a nickel. They're trying to take advantage of a situation where you have people with money coming into their country. It's a disaster.
I have never, I mean, the Olympics have had always some sort of stink and stench to them. But now it's official. It's a shitty Olympics.
That's awful.
You mean the stink? How about the stink coming from when they bought the 2002 Olympic Games, not only in Atlanta, but in Salt Lake City?
And I'm really
That's the stench.
I got to tell you something. I love Brazil, and I'm really disappointed because Brazil, 5-6 years ago, had one of the top economies in the world. It is one of the richest countries for every asset that is vital to mankind, from produce, from coffee, from chocolate. From manufacturing of many things.
World-class soccer players?
World-class soccer players. But Brazil is a very incredible country. And for it to be showcased to the world for the Olympics with, like they said that if you drink out of your toilet after you take a shit, it's cleaner than this lake.
They didn't say that.
They did.
The government said on Sunday that
they did.
All the waterways are cleared up.
I'm not like Donald Trump. You can double check what I say because it's there.
And if you have even a couple of teaspoons of that water for these kayakers and these boaters,
if you fall, forget about. Did you guys remember RoboCop when the guy fell in the toxic waste and he started falling apart in pieces?
That was Jack Nicholson in Batman as well.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was. The first Batman.
Just his skin burned.
They threw
I remember
Jack
that.
Napier. That was his name in the movie. And he comes out as Joker.
Yeah, but his skin burned. But I'm talking about the first.
I didn't see RoboCop.
The first RoboCop, the guy fell into toxic waste, and he fell apart in pieces. They say that if you fall in that lake.
You'll win the silver.
And you have a little cut. Or first of all, your eyes, you get an infection. You got one big fat fucking infection.
I'm killing over here, by the way.
And then if you don't get an infection, you get a mosquito. Kind of give you the Zika thing.
Did you see that 16-year-old Chinese girl who's at the Olympics? And she's got a net with a zipper over her bed. They've got clothing that's from head to toe with mosquito lotion, anti-mosquito lotion, actually in the suits. And the Australians have the same thing, long sleeve, long pants. But the Australians had all of their gear stolen.
What's sad is the fact that so many people have worked their ass off for 4 years to be ready for this.
Yeah.
And now, you know, obviously with these conditions, they don't want to go. Basically, the 4 years they've put into it have all gone for naught because of what's going on there. And that's the shame. I mean, that, you know, you got to really feel for the athlete.
Well, you know who's very lucky? It's the Russian athletes. They've been barred.
They're not allowed to go.
They've been barred. So they're going to be fine.
Yeah, exactly.
They're not going to have to swim in shit.
Go into a contaminated lake. Ooh, boo-hoo.
Nobody's going to steal their Rolex.
That's right.
But here's my point, guys. Here's my point. The Olympic Committee has absolutely no morality because, you know, you should be able to do a 30-day. You know when you buy a fucking house? You go do an inspection before you close.
Of course.
Right? You do a fucking inspection.
Of course.
And you know what bothers me, Eric and Billy and Johnny? Why the fuck went the Olympic Committee, who's been around for a long time, it is the biggest patriotic, nationalistic, emotional bullshit propaganda that exists, and they have no competition, just like F1 has no competition.
Hey, FIFA, don't forget FIFA. They're as crooked as Hillary Clinton.
Another corrupt organization.
Absolutely, okay. Eric.
Or Donald Trump.
Put them all together there, Johnny.
Yeah, but what I'm trying to
corruption,
say is...
Corruption.
But why wouldn't you have a fail-safe? So when you go do a 60 or 70, here's my point. I'm going to give my advice. So if you bid on the Olympics, right, you get two countries to bid. Just like in Miss Universe, you have a runner-up and a racist one.
And if you're Steve Harvey, you've got two winners.
And you got three winners. Well, today he said happy Thanksgiving. Wait a minute. But what I'm saying to you is, why wouldn't you, I'm being a little serious right now, You have two eyes, you have two ears, you have two balls, you have brakes in the front, brakes in the back. Why wouldn't you have a fail-safe? Have two countries bid on the Olympics, have the main country and a runner-up. If the main country does not fulfill the criteria within the first 90 days, then you have the second country.
It's like a play, Frank. You always have an understudy if the main 100%. Actor is unable to go. I couldn't agree with you more. It's not doing your due diligence.
But it's going.
I was in Brazil 4 years ago. I took my family. I was in the ocean all the time. None of these issues were around. But now, when you look at what's going on, and people won't even go, it's a disaster.